Good morning and welcome to today's International Space Station update. Getting a look now inside of the flight control room here at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas, as the Orbit 2 team is currently on console, monitoring systems onboard the orbiting laboratory. They are being led today by Flight Director Ron Spencer, and joining him at the Capcom console is Hal Getzelman. On board, the crew of Expedition 30 is moving through a range of experiments and maintenance work today. They are being led by NASA astronaut Dan Burbank, veteran of two shuttle missions, currently on his first extended expedition flight. He is further joined by Russian cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov there on your left and Anatoly Ivanishin on the right. They are both on their first space flights. Yesterday evening, while the crew slept, a reboost was performed with the engines on the Zvezda service module firing for about 62 seconds. That took place at 5:11 p.m. Central Time. And this is being done to correct the altitude of the International Space Station for the eventual launch of the remainder of the Expedition 30 crew coming up on December 21st. Prior concerns that a possible conjunction with a piece of Russian satellite debris were alleviated after further tracking revealed it to not be an issue. On board, the crew awoke today at about midnight Central Time, beginning their day with some morning prep work before going into their first daily planning conference, where they went over the day's activities with flight controllers around the globe in different mission control centers. Commander Burbank started his day off by quickly opening the window shutters on the U.S. lab. These had been closed prior to that reboost to shield them from any potential danger. Much of his day is being taken up working on the PACE experiment. This stands for the Preliminary Advanced Colloids Experiment, and is part of some get-ahead work being done on the station to prepare for the eventual utilization of the Advanced Colloids Experiment. He will be removing a number of cables and setting up the experiment, also doing some work with the light microscopy module, which will be taking visual readings of any of the going-ons of the experiment. After doing this, he prepared a sample and then installed such items as an LED base, some power cables, and an oil dispenser to prepare its work for the day. He also ended his work with the Integrated Cardiovascular Ambulatory Monitoring System, which has been currently taking body readings off of Commander Dan Burbank over the last few days in an ongoing investigation into cardiac atrophy, and that is the weakening of the heart muscle. This cardiac atrophy occurs during spaceflight due to the microgravity environment that the astronauts are subject to. This experiment hopes to determine how fast such atrophy develops, what causes it, and whether this is interfering with the heart's pumping or any electrical functions.
Yeah, hi, Hal. SSC-8 has photos for downlink that cover all of the fluid integrated racks, PACE activities today, closeout photos, etc. Probably need to get to Huntsville and the PD.
Okay, sounds good. We'll go get them.
Commander Burbank will later do some crew orientation time, which is set aside for about the first 2 weeks after a crew gets on board. He, of course, arrived back on November 15th, along with Shkaplerov and Ivanishin. And he will take some time out to continue to familiarize himself with the station's structure and systems. He'll end his day getting some exercise in, each crew member exercising for about 2 hours each day. He'll be using the treadmill and the ARED device, which stands for the Advanced Resistive Exercise Device. Here you see it now, the ARED functioning as a multi-purpose weightlifting device there on the station, helping the astronauts fight any bone density losses or muscle atrophy that they experience. Anton Shkaplerov began his day transferring some data from a microaccelerometer onto a laptop as part of an ongoing investigation of dynamic loads on the ISS.
Ready to copy.
He then took a good chunk of his day out to do some preventative maintenance to these Vesta service modules ventilation system.
3-2-1 that you can grab from the Columbus 1 overhead 2 Delta 2 location. And for the Crytox kit, you can go to the Columbus 1 overhead 2 Alpha 1 location and stow that there. We weren't actually expecting it to be empty. So you can just kind of stow it right there in that area. And for the oil dispensers, we're going to work a little bit better of a plan, and we'll try to get you an answer in evening DPC tonight.
Okay, copy that. Sounds good. And I guess I still have a couple of Ziploc bags. I'll check the stowage notes for these. These are the Ziploc bags for the power data cable and, well, the PACE power data cable and the PACE power data cable. I guess we want to keep those for when we swap those cables out later.
You're listening to Commander Burbank have a discussion with payload commanders over in Huntsville as he continues some cleanup work on that PACE experiment. Again, his Russian colleague Anton Shkaplerov, after he does that preventative maintenance on the Zvezda service module's ventilation system, will get some of his exercise in before then doing some familiarization work with the onboard computer network along with Anatoly Ivanishin. He'll then do some later work on the Russian coolant systems and Electron, which is the oxygen generation system on the Russian segment of the International Space Station, before moving on to some transfer activities, moving some cargo out of the 45 Progress resupply vehicle. Then the third member of the Expedition 30 crew, Anatoly Ivanishin, began his day doing some laptop activation, working alongside with experts in the Russian Mission Control Center on the ground.
Do you want to put these bags there?
And then following that, he got in some exercise and then went to work on the Matryoshka, which is a Russian experiment.
You can put those bags there.
He installed a dosimeter, which helps to measure the ionizing radiation exposure that any body may experience while on the station. That Matryoshka is a torso mannequin-like object with a number of sensors throughout it that help scientists measure the amount of radiation any astronaut on board the station may be experiencing. Later, he did his familiarization work with that onboard computer network alongside Anton Shkaplerov, and then did some item transfer ops of his own, moving some items out of their Soyuz launch vehicle, and then ending his day with some exercise on one of the treadmills. Crew will end their day with a second daily planning conference, again talking to flight controllers around the globe, before they move into their scheduled sleep period at 3:30 p.m. Central Time.